Thanks for joining us here on the web. Granite Staters are cleaning up after a blast of winter weather hit New Hampshire. For the latest on cleanup efforts, WMUR's Andy Hirschberger is in Derry. The snow began falling early this morning.
This storm was forecast for days, so highway crews in Derry were prepared.
Started treating the roads last night around 9:30, 10 o'clock. It accumulated very slowly at the onset. Around 3 o'clock, 3:30 this morning, we started hitting the roads, plowing. We typically wait till it's about 2 inches on the road before we'll start scraping.
The morning was cold and the snow steady as people took to the roads for the morning commute.
Not too bad. They're just starting hitting the secondary roads now, so not too bad. Yeah, I'm sure the highways will be fine, but I got four-wheel drive, so not so bad.
In Massachusetts, the highway really wasn't plowed, but as soon as I got up here, it was plowed.
Well, they're slick, real slick. Coming down the hills out of East Derry is treacherous. Stay at home.
And many people did stay home as schools were canceled across the state. As the sun started to rise, the job of digging out began. What started out as the light, fluffy stuff turned thick and heavy as the snow started mixing with some rain.
It's all right. It's ready for Christmas, you know. No problems. I don't have little ones. I don't have a schedule today, so it's fine by me.
It's wet because of the rain, but it's fine. You know, it blows off good, as you can see.
Highway crews are expected to keep working through most of the afternoon, and officials want everyone to be careful on the drive home.
This is New England, and if people just maintain, you know, just drive slow, have good tires, and maintain a good distance between them and the cars in front of them, they should be safe.
Highway officials say warmer temperatures in the afternoon will work in drivers' favor, but as temperatures dip this evening, drivers could be dealing with some icy conditions. They're asking everybody to take it easy out there. New details are expected in an apparent homicide in Dover. On Saturday, police responded to a home on Three Rivers Road for a reported shooting. The attorney general's office says a man was killed. An autopsy is expected to take place today. Authorities have not released the victim's name. No arrests have been made, but police say there does not appear to be any threat to the public. Police in Portsmouth are investigating after a baby was brought to the hospital with a skull fracture. The six-month-old was transported to Boston Children's Hospital yesterday. At this point, it's not clear how the baby was injured or how seriously the child was hurt. A Manchester teenager was arrested after police say they discovered more than 16 grams of cocaine in his car. An officer pulled over 18-year-old Luis Augusto Gurrieros for an inspection sticker violation Saturday. Inside his car, authorities say they discovered 13 small plastic bags filled with cocaine. The suspect is charged with possession of a controlled drug with intent to distribute. He was also charged with operating without a valid license. A Manchester man accused of threatening another man with a gun is due in court today. 18-year-old Anthony King, scheduled to be arraigned on charges that include criminal threatening. Police say he showed up at the victim's home Saturday night armed with a gun. He fled the scene but was arrested soon after. News 9 has learned that a man involved in a murder-suicide in Maine was a former pastor in New Hampshire. Authorities say Dan Randall shot and killed his 27-year-old daughter before turning the gun on himself. The murder-suicide happened Thursday in Hebron, Maine. Online records show Randall was a pastor at the Church Congregational in Lee in the early 2000s. Police say he had just gotten out of an alcohol treatment facility and purchased the gun the same day. Starting tonight at 5, calling for an immediate investigation into potential election hacking. Tonight, how Trump and other lawmakers are responding. Plus, some fresh snow is helping ski resorts in the region. How some say the season is starting off. That does it for us here on the web. Thanks for joining us. We wish you a great afternoon.